In conclusion, Yeshua is the bridegroom. The New Jerusalem is the bride. It's a beautiful city coming down as a bride, decorated with all kinds of stones in the 12 tribes. I would like to, and all of this leads back to the garden. Simchat Torah, the last day, the concluding of the Torah reading, starts again in Genesis in the beginning of the garden. God is cyclical. And the Lord is bringing us back those who are His, who He gave the right to become the children of God, to come back with Him into restored fellowship, the tabernacle of His presence, because Yeshua made a way, but we have to do it His way. Psalm 45, the great bridegroom warrior. He saved us from sin the first time. The next time He's coming to save us as the warrior king. He's going to deliver us. Stand and see your deliverance. My heart is stirred by a noble theme. I address my verses to the king. My tongue is the pen of an expert scribe. You are the most handsome of men. Gracious speech flows from your lips, for God has blessed you forever. Warrior, strap your sword at your thigh. Gird on your splendor and majesty. In your majesty, succeed. Ride on in the cause of truth, meekness, and righteousness. May your right hand teach you awesome things. Your arrows are sharp. The people fall under you as they penetrate the hearts of the king's enemies. Your throne, O God, will last forever and ever. You rule your kingdom with a scepter of equity. You have loved righteousness and hated wickedness. Therefore, God, your God, has anointed you with the oil of joy in preference to your companions. Your robes are all fragrant with myrrh, aloes, and cassia. From ivory palaces, stringed instruments bring you joy. Daughters of kings are among your favorites. At your right hand stands the queen in gold from Ophir. Listen, daughter, think, pay attention. Forget your own people and your father's house, and the king will desire your beauty, for he is your lord, so honor him. Then the daughter of Zor, the richest of peoples, will court your favor with gifts. Inside the palace, the king's daughter looks splendid, attired in checkerwork embroidered with gold. In brocade, she will be led to the king, to you with the virgins in her retinue. They will be led in with gladness and joy. They will enter the king's palace. You will have sons to succeed your ancestors. You will make them princes in all the land. I will make your name known through all generations. Thus the peoples will praise you forever and ever. And let me reiterate, then I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them and be their God. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away. Then he who sat on the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said to me, write, for these words are true and faithful. Revelation 21, 2 through 5. And again, I conclude with, and the Spirit, the outflowing of the waters of the precious Holy Spirit, holy, 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 and the bride say, come, and let him hear say, come, and let him who thirst come. Whoever desires, let him take the waters of life freely, surely. He who testifies to these things, Yeshua says, surely I am coming quickly. Even so, come, Lord Jesus. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Amen.